Altoids box that I found in Hungary on my LDS mission. And when I first saw it, I thought, whoa, it's super old. It looks like one of the antique ones or something. It expired in 2006. So it's only 10 years old. And when I found it in like 2008, it wasn't even that old. Or I guess, when was I on my mission? Anyway, that's when it was. So I opened it. And it has this little foam stuck in it, and it has an assortment of colors. Pink, blue, orange. And this is a scripture marking kit for when you read your Bible and your Book of Mormon, and you want to mark significant passages. Okay, this is a little blade for, so if I can do this with one hand. For sharpening it. Okay. One second. Alright. Hang on. Okay. So you're gonna look at this while I open this little blade. All these different colors. Okay. So I got it out. Kind of the little white part slides out, and then the blade slides forward. This whole thing's actually detachable. You can pull it out, but this keeps a little handle on it for you, and you would sharpen the colors so that you can make really fine lines under the scripture passages. And some snarky elder wrote, he scribbled out naranja, naranja, and orange, and put purple. So I thought that was funny. I just thought this was really interesting. I haven't been able to bring myself to get rid of it. Oh, we even put a little piece of wood in so that everything would kind of fit nicely. I don't want to get rid of it, and I haven't started using the crayons myself. I've been using crayons lately. Because it's like such a neat little setup. It makes me want to go get a new copy of the Book of Mormon or like a new copy of the Old Testament and just use this little set to mark through things like this elder. I'm assuming it was an elder because the apartment we were in had elders in it for years before I moved in with my sister companion. So I'm assuming it was an elder, but it could have been a sister. It's just so neatly put together, so tidy. Anyway, isn't that cool? A scripture marking set that some missionary made for himself. So now that I've made this video and I've kind of documented this really cool item, maybe I'll just add the crayons to my crayon collection and get rid of the box, which isn't an antique like I thought it was, and see if one of my nephews or nieces wants the little blade to whittle wood with or something. Anyway, that's all. Just my thought for today on this little thing. Okay, have a good day. Bye.